I am Santosh Gayankar. Today's concept is about thick cylinder. I am directly writing the formula of thick cylinder here. A tangential stress or hoop stress, when P naught is given, this is the formula I am going to use it here. And radial stresses, this is the formula I am going to use. Now for hoop stress it is positive, for radial stress it is negative. When P naught is given, what is P naught? P naught is nothing but external fluid pressure is given. If P naught is not given, then you have to substitute 0 here. If you substitute 0, you will arrive this formula. P naught is nothing but internal pressure. Di is nothing but internal diameter. D naught is external diameter. R is the radius of cylinder. And this is the formula for finding the outer diameter. D naught is nothing but 2T plus Di. By using this one, we are going to solve the problems very fast. The first problem is, this is the first problem, a pipe of 500 mm internal diameter. Internal diameter is given here, 500 mm is given, internal diameter, that is Di is equal to 500 mm and thickness is given 75 mm is filled with a fluid at a pressure of 6 Newton per mm square. There is no external, therefore you have to consider Pi. Pi is nothing but 6 Newton mm square. If external is given, then you have to consider P naught. Otherwise you have to consider internal pressure. Find the maximum and minimum hoop stress across the cross section. We have to find out the maximum minimum hoop stress we have to find out, or that is nothing but tangential stress we have to find out. And also sketch the radial pressure and hoop stress distribution across the section. This is the one of the video problem which is repeated rapidly, more oftenly. Now these are the data they have given it, and we have to find out sigma theta max and sigma theta mean through the diagram we have to obtain. Now I will use the formula, because P naught is not given, therefore I will directly use this formula. P naught will be 0 here. If you substitute 0, you will obtain here this formula. I will consider this formula directly. Hoop stress sigma theta is nothing but Pi Di square D naught square minus Di square 1 plus D naught square divided by 4 R. R is nothing but radius. Here we have to find out the outer radius, mean radius and internal radius we have to find out. This is the formula. Substitute the value. Pi is nothing but 6. Di is nothing but 500. Square divided by D naught. We don't know the D naught. How to find out D naught? The formula for D naught. D naught is nothing but, this is the formula I am going to use. D naught is nothing but 2T plus Di. 2T plus Di. What is 2T? 2 into thickness. 2 into thickness. Thickness is nothing but 75 plus Di is nothing but 500. The answer for D naught is 650 mm. Substitute here. 650 square minus 500 square 1 plus 650 square divided by 4 R square. The obtained value for this term will be 8.695 into this term, 1 plus 650 square divided by 4 R square. We have to find out this R term. Now I will go for radial stress. This is the radial stress formula. Radial stress I am directly using here. I will derive this formula in the next videos. Sigma r is equal to pi di square divided by d naught square minus di square 1 minus. In the radial stress you have to take minus, in the hoop stress you have to take plus, minus d naught square divided by 4 r square. Substitute the value 6 into 500 square divided by 650 square minus 500 square into 1 minus 650 square divided by 4 r square. We have to find out this r term. If you substitute further, the value will be 8.695 1 minus 650 square divided by 4 r square. Now I will go for a table here, table which contain radius r in terms of mm, tangential stress or hoop stress, tangential stress or hoop stress in terms of Newton mm square, sigma theta, and radial stress. This is the one of the easiest method. By using this formula you can directly get the sketch for the pressure, radial pressure and hoop stress. Sigma r is equal to Newton per mm square. Now first I will write this part as a ri rm r naught. Ri is nothing but internal diameter 500, that is di divided by 2. 500 divided by 2 is nothing but 250 mm. Now you have to go for r naught. R naught is nothing but d naught divided by 2. D naught is nothing but 650 divided by 2. The answer is 325. Now rm is nothing but difference of these two, that is 250 plus 325 divided by 2. The answer is 287.5 mm. After getting this value, now sigma theta, substitute here the value, here the r value you have to substitute. Now with the help of the calculator I am going to substitute the values. 08.695 into 1 plus 650 square divided by 4 into ri value, that is 250. I will substitute. Square. The answer is 23. I will write here 23.38. Now just replace the minus sign here. You have to replace the minus sign, you will get the radial stress. Replace the minus sign, you will get the radial stress minus 5.99, that is approximately minus 6. Similarly for RM, this 250 value has to be changed with 287.5, and this will be changed with positive sign. That is 19.901 or 6, and replace with negative sign, you will get RM value. This will be minus 2.416. go for last value. It is already minus. I have directly substituted the values here. 325, which will be 0 here. Go for positive sign. In this way, you have to obtain the table. In this way, you have to obtain the tangential stress and radial stress. Now, I am going to draw the diagram. For the tangential stress, I will draw tangential stress. This is nothing but I will consider Ri 250 mm, Rm 287.5 mm and R naught 325. This is will be R mm in this direction. Now graph obtained will be in this way. The first value will be sigma theta is nothing but this is sigma theta in terms of Newton per mm square. This we call as oof stress or tangential stress. The first value is 23.38 on 250. Second value is around here, 19.806 Newton per mm square. Third value is here, 17.39 Newton per mm square. This will be sigma theta max and this will be sigma theta mean. And this part, this diagram we referred as a tangential stress. Tangential stress or hoop stress. Hoop stress. And second, I will draw the radial stress. Same diagram I will consider here. Bottom I will consider because it is negative here. Sigma r Newton per mm square. Same value. Same Ri value will remain same, Rm, R naught. The graph obtained will be here in this way. Because it is a zero and it will be zero, you have to touch this. Now first value will be 6 Newton per mm square. The second value will be minus 2.416 Newton per mm square and third will be zero. If you measure the difference here, measure the difference, it will be 17.39 Newton per mm square. If you measure the difference of these two, it is also a 17.39. That means 19.806 minus 2.416, 17.39. If you measure the difference of this part, it is also 17.39 Newton per mm square. In some time they will consider this as a value as A in the textbook. This is one of the best method to solve the problem and easiest method. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.